with the pandemic and so many other things that have gone on in our country. We see it every day on the news, but it's still a blessing that we're still here. You've lost so many loved ones along the way. So if you wake up in the morning, that means you made the wake-up list. And that's enough to be thankful for. Okay? I don't know if you guys got your iPhones or your iPads. I got a little scripture I want to share with you tonight. All right? While we are here and while we're celebrating Black history and celebrating the struggle of our people, but also celebrating the triumph and where it's brought us to. You know, the things that we've had to deal with and where it's brought us to. If we go to the book of Psalms, Psalms 34, and just one verse out of there that stuck out to me when I was thinking about this particular event, and I wanted to know where can I go? What is it that I can talk about tonight? So Psalms 34 and 19, I'm going to read it in two different translations. The King James Version reads, "Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all." I'm going to say that again. It's from the King James Version, Psalm 34, verse 19. It says, "Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all." If we go to the Amplified Version, okay, the Amplified Version of Psalms 34, 19 says, "Many hardships and perplexing circumstances confront the righteous, but the Lord rescues him out of them all." Let me say it again. Many hardships and perplexing circumstances confront the righteous, but the Lord rescues him out of them all. So briefly today, I want to talk about the topic, "Nothing Just Happens."
Hello.
That's my topic tonight.
Hello.
Nothing Just Happens. Can we bow our heads in prayer?
Amen.
Dear Lord, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for another time to be able to go before your people and share the word that you've given us. We ask that you hide me behind the cross so no flesh will glory in your sight. Give me the words that you'd want me to say to these people tonight so that they may be encouraged, uplifted, blessed, and prepared to take on any struggle that may come their way in the coming weeks and months and years. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Nothing just happens. That is where I'm coming from tonight. Many times we ask ourselves, and let me just say this first and foremost, one of the biggest questions that humans ask, period, man or woman, is why. That's the biggest question. If you ever look that up and you ever research it, because I've done some research on it, out of all of the words or all of the questions that are ever asked, why, W-H-Y, is the biggest one. People ask, why am I going through this? Why is this happening? Why did I lose this loved one? Or why did this person walk away from me? Or why did I lose this what I consider to be blessing, or why is this going the way it's going, or why am I dealing with this circumstance? We always have that question, and that question is always why. We say why, and here's another thing. We even ask ourselves, why are we going through so much hell when we are just trying to make it to heaven? If you ever ask yourself that question, it seems like the closer you're working towards getting yourself prepared to get to heaven, it seems like that's the most hell you deal with. And we ask ourselves this question a lot. Just be honest. There are times, I know a lot of times they teach us not to question God and not to question his plan and not to question things, but there are questions that come in our minds. And there are times when we ask. And hopefully I can clarify some of that for you tonight. Too often we seek out the purpose for why we go through what we go through. Rarely do we ever examine the reason why we go through what we go through. I'm going to say it again. Sure. Too often we seek out the purpose for why we go through what we go through, but rarely do we ever examine the reason why we go through what we go through. Now, even though the word purpose and reason is closely connected, and in many instances, you can find those words connected even in the definition, but when you look at those words and study those words individually, they have two different definitions and two different meanings. Even though they can work, they can intermingle, and they can be one and unified in the same, but they do have two separate meanings. Purpose, the definition of purpose, is something set up as an object or end to be attained. Again, purpose is something set up as an object or end to be attained. In other words, what you're going through, you actually know the purpose or where it is you're trying to get through. In other words, if you're trying to get to New York, you know you got to go through several steps. Either you're driving down the highway or you're catching the bus. But you know what you're going through and you know the purpose of it because you know where your destination is and what you're trying to achieve. Right. Reason, the definition of reason is a cause, explanation, or justification for an action or event. Let me say that again. Reason is a cause, explanation, or justification for an action or event. In other words, the reason or the reasoning for what you're dealing with is going to deal with the cause. It's going to give you an explanation as to why you're going through what you're going through. And a lot of times we miss this, and I know I miss it all the time. The Bible gives us a clear understanding as to why sometimes we go through the things we go through. And it is that many are the afflictions of the righteous. What they don't want to tell you sometimes is that just by deciding to live righteously and be righteous, you're going to automatically be on the devil's hit list. Sure. Immediately. The minute that you decide that you're not going to go on the dark side, that you're going to walk in the light, you are immediately thrusted into that list of people that the enemy seeks to send after to attack you. And I don't want you to think, because there's a lot of folks who think, just like Job's wife and Job's friends, when he was going through what he was going through, they started to tell him that maybe you're going through that because God doesn't appreciate what you're doing, or maybe you're not pleasing in God's sight. They'll try to put seeds of doubt and seeds of discord within your mind and make you think that because you can't seem to get enough money in your pocket to pay the bills, or because you might not be able to get enough food in your house, that maybe God isn't pleased with you. That's not always the case. Many times, because you are righteous, because you have decided to walk in a righteous way, because you've decided to stay in the light, the enemy is going to always bother you. If you're not on his side, he's going to bother you. Sure. The moment that you really should worry is when he doesn't bother you. Because he's not going to bother anybody that's on his team. He's going to make sure they're taken care of. So if he's bothering you, then that's a moment for you to rejoice. Because that proves to you that you must be doing something right.
Something correct.
You have to be under some sort of pressure sometimes when you're standing up for what's right.
And
that's one of the biggest things. When we talk about Black history, and we talk about Black leaders who have, you know, the Freedom Riders who got beat down and got hosed down, and sometimes the buses they were on got burned, and it continues to this day. And you see what they went through because they stood up for what they believed was right. And sometimes when you stand up for what you believe is right, everything is going to seem to fall down. But you can't allow what you're looking at to determine or define where you're going to go. Just because everything is looking down does not mean things aren't going up or things aren't looking up. You got to understand that. You're facing something right now. And I know there's some people watching from home, and you're facing something right now. You're in a dilemma, and you're asking yourself, if God loves me, why is he going to make me go through this? Or I'm doing everything I know to do that is right in his sight, but I don't understand why I'm continuing to go through the storms I'm going through. I want you to be of good cheer. I want you to be of good heart, and just know that because you have decided to walk in the way that you've decided to walk in, that you're going to face some troubles.
True.
Things are not always going to work out for you.
Nope.
A lot of times they may tell you, if you're just getting into church, or if you're just coming into the knowledge of God, they'll try to tell you that everything is just going to be fine. That's a lie. I'm here to tell you, sometimes the hell will get started at that very moment.
Preach.
Because the devil wants to get you back. He doesn't like the fact that he lost you. So he's trying to do everything he can to bring you back.
Right.
And if you notice, if you came out of something, like I came from stuff. I came from a life of drinking. I came from messing with marijuana and things like that. I came from that life. And sometimes when you're going through things, the devil will tempt you and say, hey, you know what? You can relieve your stress by just going back to what you used to do. Even that, he'll even do that to you. He'll say, hey, just go back to that, and I'll make sure everything will be all right for you. And you'll begin to think that maybe things will get better if I just go back to that. I'm here to encourage you. It's going to get rough. It may get even rougher. But I can guarantee you at the end of the road, and not even the end of the road. Let me say this, too. It's not going to be when you die. You're going to see yourself get some blessings right here in life. You're going to see right here. Trust me. There's no such thing as a testimony without a test.
Tell it.
You understand what I'm telling you? There's no such thing as a testimony without a test.
Tell
So in order for you to get that testimony about what God did for you, he's going to have to let you go through some things.
Hello.
And that's what we don't understand. Sometimes the trials and tribulations that come in our life are not always there to destroy us. They're to make us stronger.
Stronger.
And if you look at your life right now, and you go back the last 10 years, and you look at all the things you went through, when you started going through what you went through 10 years ago, in the back of your mind, you thought you weren't going to make it.
Amen.
And here you are, 10 years later, you made it.
Amen.
You see what I mean? And when you look 10 years in the future, you're going to see that you made it again. You got to look at yourself. You got to look at it. Exactly.
Where we at?
They've been, exactly. That's what they do. Even your friends have the tendency to call you off sometimes. Let me tell you a personal story. I ran for the Board of Education, and you know, this is all in context. I ran in 2012. I won in 2012, and you know, I lost my re-election bid in 2015, and I ran three more times. Elvis Churchport, no, I ran three more times, and people kind of said, "Why are you even wasting your time running? You're never going
to
win again."
Time to waste.
And in 2019, when I ran, I went home that night after the election was over. I went home. I didn't even go to City Hall for the results.
Hello.
And all of a sudden, I got a phone call. They said, "Where are you?" I said, "I'm at home. I'm just relaxing."
Hello.
Because I thought it was going to be the same way as the other years. They said, "Get down here. You're basically the top vote getter in all the districts." After three times.
Yes.
Losing. Yes, so you're going through things right now. Trust me, I get it. I'm going through things myself. But I know I have focus enough to know that what you're dealing with right now is not going to be compared to what God's going to give you later on.
Amen.
And you got to hold on to that. If you have nothing else to hold on to the fact that where you are right now is not where you're always going to be. And what you're dealing with right now, the hardships, the struggles that you're dealing with right now, that's not your permanent address. That might be a temporary location for now, a temporary stop, like a truck stop where you're just there for a moment because God got to show you some things. And you know, he has to humble you sometime, so he'll allow you to experience what it means to be hungry. He will. I mean, I know folks don't like to talk like that, and they don't like to go there, but God will allow little things to happen to you. Just like he said when the devil was going to tempt Job, and he went to God, and he said, "The reason why Job hasn't went against you is because you've given him everything he wants. If you take the hedge from around him, I'll make him curse you to your face."
Hello.
So what did he say? He said, "All right, you can go do that, but you can't touch his life." And here's the thing. Sometimes God will permit trials and tribulations to get all around you, but they won't touch your life.
Hello.
Now, we know we have seen, right, hundreds of thousands of people have died from the pandemic, right? They say that if you had pre-existing conditions and you got COVID-19, that you would not survive, right? December 15th, I was diagnosed with COVID-19. I had high blood pressure, had, you know, diabetes, asthma. The newspapers were calling me because they thought that there was going to be a vacant seat on the school board. They were saying, "You sure you're really going to be able to survive with those pre-existing conditions?" I'm here today, aren't I? I got through it. I went through it. There was a couple of days in that period where I couldn't even walk. My family would tell you, I couldn't even walk. They had to bring me everything. I had to crawl to the bathroom. And I kept asking, why is this when I'm helping the community? I'm serving everybody. Sometimes I got to make you feel what people are dealing with. So when you go to them, you're more empathetic to what they're going through. Because sometimes when you speak to people, we like to speak over them. Or we like to speak down to them. So sometimes what God will do is he'll allow you to experience
even to
what the people you have to minister to are going to go through. So you can tell them, hey, instead of saying, "Let me look that up and see how you get through it," you can say, "I've been through it and got through it."
Yep.
And you're going to make it through it because I got through it.
Yes, Lord.
And I can show you how to do it. So if you're going through something right now, God is taking you through what he's taking you through so that you can be able to help somebody else through what they're going through.
Let me say that again.
God is taking you through what he's taking you through so you can help somebody else go through what they're going through. It's not always about you. Sometimes God will be so proud of you that he wants to make you an example of how you hold on to God even when things are going crazy. Sometimes God is so proud of you that he wants to show you as an example to the world of how you trust him even when you can't trace him.
Hello.
Sometimes that's what God does.
Yes.
He wants to show you off to the world, to show everybody that you can go through pure hell and still make it to heaven.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? My encouragement to you, because y'all know I'm not a long-winded speaker. I just like to get to the point, get you what you need, and move on. You know, my mother taught me that when I was young. I started preaching when I was 12. She said the three T's, take your text, take off, and take your seat.
Don't waste a whole lot of time.
Say what you need to say and let it go. So I'm going to let it go with that. Trust me, what you're going through right now and the circumstances that you're dealing with right this very moment are not going to be what defines your outcome, but it's going to be what makes you who you are. So when you get there, you can tell people, I didn't get here on an easy train. I had to crawl here. I went through fire. I went through hell. I even got the smoke on my shirt to show you that I had to walk through flames of fire to get where I am now. Amen. But I made it, and because I made it, you can make it. That's the best testimony you could ever have, is to tell somebody that because I made it through, you can make it through. So everybody that's watching, everybody that's here, I just want y'all to know, we're going to make it. It's not easy right now. I know things are hard. I know things are difficult. But I want you to remember within your mind that you are going to get through this. I want you to know that. All right? So that's it.
And I can clarify exactly everything that he said. Mm-hmm. I seen this young man come up.
That's right.
And I know
and for he witnessed
fact,
it.
And what he's saying is truth.
Indeed.
So therefore, if you believe in God, if you believe in yourself, you can have everything that you need to have.
Absolutely.
And there's a lot of people in this world right now that if you talk to them, just reach out and talk to them.
True.
You'll find out there's some people that can help you.
Absolutely.
That you never even know that they have the existence to do so.
And it's a brother that knows you for years. There you have it.